could just be the beginning.
Beginning of what?
All-out war.
When director JJ Abrams first embarked on his Star Trek adventure back in 2009, the movie had its world premiere here in Australia. Well, the sequel, Star Trek Into Darkness, is having its first outing in Australia once again. Not just because it's good luck, but because we have some of the biggest and best Star Trek fans right here.
It's certainly wonderful to be back. The people of Sydney could not be more welcoming, more kind, and we're very grateful, really are.
That's a great suit, man.
Look at this.
Look who it is, Angela Bishop.
Hi, Angela.
How are you, Zach?
Good, how are you?
Good to see you. Look very sharp.
Oh, very thanks. Sharp.
That's sweet of you. Too.
Yeah, this is a great suit, too.
God, look at that.
All right, there, we can lose them there.
You are suggesting that we utilize the passage between the approaching structures. This ship will not fit.
We'll fit.
Captain, we will not fit.
We'll fit!
Back in Australia where it all began, is that a good vibe for you for the second time around?
It's such a great place to start.
I mean, we're only here for like 2 days at a time. We see the inside of a hotel room, but...
We took a
helicopter tour the other day that was incredible, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful city, and we're very happy to show it.
Has Zoe Saldana, who of course starred in Avatar, prepared you for seeing yourself in 3D?
I don't know if anything quite prepares one for that, but I'm super psyched about this movie. I can't wait to see it. I think JJ's a genius, and this film is going to deliver in spades.
You have to say that because he's standing next to you. But
And he paid me. But yeah.
Is it great to have Zachary, Chris, and Karl here for this?
Oh, yeah. I mean, they're a wonderful group. You know, the whole cast is spectacular. So any combination is wonderful, and Chris and Zach really outdo themselves in this movie.
You know, in the first one, we introduced the characters, and this one we get a real chance to kind of explore the different colors of these two really interesting characters. And for Kirk, I think he's a man that's ruled by passion and heart, and Spock obviously is a man that's ruled otherwise, and they're kind of two journeys collide, and they learn a great deal from one another, and really it's because of the other that each of them gets to kind of fully realize who they are.
Well, the movie is definitely a big, fun, grand adventure, and I think the people of Australia seem to enjoy that, so I do too, so I'm really excited to show it to everyone.
No ship should go down without her, Captain.